Okay, so here's the situation a potential customer asked us. What he gets in are Word files, and he gets in these Word files, and that's all he gets. He doesn't get any fonts or images. Now, the fonts he has are standard, you know, system fonts, but the problem is the images are embedded in the Word file. So I made a little test here to exhibit the situation. But what he needs to do is get these Word files into a professional desktop publishing layout, in his case, Adobe InDesign, CS6. And he needs the images, but he needs them to manipulate and finalize the layout for print. So here we have a little Word file with images embedded. And we have some text just to show you finally what our PDF2DTP can do, because that's what we're going to show you here, our PDF to InDesign, how that can help get a Word file with images embedded to help you get those images freed up and in the correct position within the final layout. We just got the Word file in here. We're going to then go up here and do File, Save As. We're going to choose Format, PDF, and we're going to save that down to the desktop. All right, so now we're going to quit Word. Let's go check out the PDF. Here's the PDF now. Preview on the Mac looks the same. Same would apply on Windows. We can open up that PDF, and there we see everything just like it was, right? All right, so let's get out of Preview now. And now we're going to pop up into InDesign, CS6 in this case. It will also work in CC, CS5.5, or CS5. Up top in InDesign, once you have purchased Markzware's PDF2DTP, which is a very affordable and useful plugin, and you'll see some of our other tools like Quark InDesign. And PDF2DTP, just go up here to Convert PDF. We select the PDF we just created right there. We click Open. We agree to those preferences. And the conversion begins and is done before I can say too much, which is probably pretty good because I like to talk, I think. At least that's what people tell me. Anyway, so here we have it. There you go. It is now exactly like the PDF and the Word file. Well, exactly like the Word file you just saw. We get everything in stylized, all fonts, but most importantly, you see we get all the images with the exact attributes as used within the original Word file. Now, one last thing to show you. And these are all linked images, which is really cool. See, this file is, you know, ready to roll, apart from any additions or changes you might need. And I should note, there might be some touching up going from Word to PDF to InDesign. There might be some shifting, some you know, tables might have some issues. We do convert tables, but there might be some issues with those at times. And transparency can sometimes be tricky. There's some things you might have to touch up, but I think that's quite logical. Just like converting from Japanese to German to English, something's going to be lost along the way. You're going to have to address that. Boy, I tell you, all these phones are, you know, dinging and ringing with all their funky sounds these days. Okay, so now we'll go to our desktop again. Let me get out of InDesign. And what you're going to see here is the job folder. And in that job folder is everything. The InDesign file with the linked images that were just in this Word file over here. So, folks, pretty amazing. A way to get Word files with embedded images right on over into InDesign via a PDF and Markzware's PDF2DTP with images included at resolution and the stylization used. We'll click here on the PDF2DTP bundle on Markzware.com, and you can see you can get more information over here, including videos and technical details. There's also a bunch of testimonials on YouTube I'll put a link to down here, and you'll see how incredible this tool is for a very affordable price for Macintosh or Windows. Check it out today. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us on sales@markzware.com, and we'll be happy to help you out, do a little test conversion on a PDF for you if you're not sure. But once again, this really works fantastic. There might be some touching up needed, but as you just saw, there's so many uses for PDF2DTP. It's one of those plugins you just really need to have in your toolbox. David Ling from Markzware, wishing you a fantastic day. Signing off for now.